Breaking news. It has been confirmed that the GNU, right, Government of National Confusion, they have officially reached an agreement, and in that agreement, they look at the DA, and they've confirmed that they are now willing more than ever to enter the coalition, to enter the Government of National Unit. Now, I know one of you guys will say, but why, right? Maybe the reason the DA decided to agree, on this thing, it is simply because it was reported not long ago that MK Political Party, I saw such reports that MK Political Party, they met with the ANC, and their intentions was that they met to say, listen, remove EDA from this. We will join this thing, and you don't have to go through all these problems that you are currently going through, right? So after that, we've also heard that it's also a matter of fact. The one that we can say we've heard is the one-year ANC, MK in the ANC that they met in Polokwane. But the EFF, they wrote a public letter saying to the ANC, remove DA and Freedom Fund Plus, we will enter these things, and you don't have to go through all of this. So for me, I suspect that right there, it was politics 101. Like I told you, this year we're about to be educated, and we're about to learn more, and it's gonna be politics 101. I strongly believe that this would have been a strategic approach by the MK and the EFF to say, they don't wanna agree that the DA is doing this to the ANC. So they don't want to agree to their confusion. Okay, it's fine. Let's rather push them and force them into that situation where they agree, whether they like that or not. You know what I'm saying? So that it's clear we have a government, we then deal with them once they are now in government, right? So it could have been a I highly suspect a political strategy to say, let's push them into the agreement, because now they are about to, you know what I'm saying? But they don't want to enter this whole shenanigans. So let's rather push them. And then what? The rest is history, right? Because the DA finally agreed to enter those things. So I'm about to unpack all of those things, provided you are interested. But if you are interested, well, there are things that I find it not interesting. If you don't do this,
if you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Now, there was an article released by IOL. The heading of the article, the reporter here is just written staff reporter. Right. As of me reading this article, it has been released 2 hours ago. The heading of the article says, deal done. ANC and DA reached agreement after reviving talks. The ANC and the DA has finally reached a deal over their involvement in the cabinet, right? Leaked letters and public spats. And two parties are believed to have made a breakthrough on Saturday after a crisis talks, right? Sources close to the negotiations told IOL that talks had collapsed last week due to several leaked letters, with both parties accusing each other of negotiating in bad faith. However, Saturday's meeting resurrected the negotiations and hastened the deal. The source confirmed that the DA will assume control of six key cabinet positions and local ministries as part of the power-sharing agreement. Racist. Hey, why racist? What now? So I'm reading something else now. So remember I said to you it could have been politics 101, in a sense that they did not want to agree on anything and everything that the ANC was saying. They wanted more, right? Remember that the ANC was offering them six positions and they wanted nine positions, right? So if you have the MK party, hey guys, this is going to be very interesting, right? If you have the MK party and the EFF saying, hey, remove DA, remove what? I'm going to give you a practical example. If you are purchasing an apartment or if you're purchasing a property somewhere and you are busy negotiating and you are being told that, listen, you as a buyer, you come up with your own negotiations and everything, and then you want to negotiate your price, and the seller is saying, listen, man, let's agree on this price. These are the price I'm offering. And whenever you want to bring down the price even way further, but remember, as a seller, you want the product by fire, by force. And now, what happens to your mind when you now suddenly hear that there are serious competitors, and not just competitors, and it's not just the talks, and now you see the evidence? You will eventually agree to what is on the table, like it or not. The departments that I'm going to be looking at that the DA got is the following: basic education, public works and infrastructure, communications and digital technologies, right? Forensic, forestry, fisheries, and environment. Agriculture is also one of the things, right? So let me count. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where's the other one? Because it says 6. So they got 5. 5, right? People within the ANC are not thrilled, but the deal is done. The DA has put forward their positions that they have a particular set on skills that they can improve these ministries. We will have to wait and see, right? Further details on the composition of the cabinet and the specific plans for each ministry are expected to be announced in the coming days, right? With the negotiations with the ANC concluded, it is expected that President Ramaphosa will announce his cabinet within the next 48 hours, says a source, right? Like I said, today, this year, we're going to be learning a very, 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 we're going to be learning politics 101. And believe you me when I say, or if I say, we're going to be learning politics 101 in 2024. Because if you are ANC, if you are MK party, and if you are EFF, for instance, and you see that, okay, these people are playing Black Mampatil, so... And then you just want to push them into these things. Mina, I'm still saying this could be politics 101. Believe you me when I say that. But another interesting thing to look at this is that when you strategically look at this, right? For the first time, you're gonna be having MK party. You're gonna be having MK party. What is it? MK party and EFF holding DA and ANC accountable, right? So it's gonna be easier to deal with them once they are in government, right? and they will never dispute any corruptions. So we're going to learn quite a lot from this year's coalition.